Thank you, Madam Speaker. I'm grateful to you that you have given me an opportunity to speak on this bill. Ma'am, congratulating our Honorable Finance Minister and endorsing the thoughts of Shri Sanjay Jaiswal ji and Subhash ji. Further, I want to say that the need to bring this Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code Amendment Bill 2017 arose because the similar persons who, with their misconduct, contributed to the defaults of the companies or are otherwise undesirable, may misuse this situation due to lack of prohibition or restrictions to participate in the resolution or liquidation process, the gain or regain control of the corporate debtor. This may undermine the process laid down in the code, as unscrupulous person would be seen to be rewarded at the expense of the creditors. Ma'am, I really find it strange why the previous government didn't notice the perils of the old Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code. Again, ma'am, what exactly do we want to achieve and change by this bill is that we want to provide clarity as to the persons who can submit resolution plan in response to an invitation made by the resolution professional. Second, ma'am, also to provide for making certain persons ineligible for being resolution applicants. This is also a matter of concern, ma'am, that if a person who is responsible for the downfall of any enterprise and he wants to take advantage of that situation should not be permissible, or he becomes ineligible for any reason for that matter. So that why the need arose to bring this ordinance, and now we are converting into a bill. Well, also, I think that it has been after much consideration that provided that the committee of the creditors shall approve the resolution plan by a vote of not less than 75% of voting share of the financial creditors after considering the feasibility and viability of the resolution plan. So it's not that that we are giving a very open opportunity that anybody could misuse of this bill, ma'am. So at least 75% of the votes should be in his favor so that he can apply for or give a resolution. Ma'am, also this bill also deals to disallow the sale of property to a person who is ineligible to be a resolution applicant in the case of liquidation of the corporate debt. Ma'am, earlier, if a company defaults, there are at least four different legal routes available to the debtors and the creditors. This could lead to multiple negotiations, multiple penalties, etc., for the debtor, compounding his plight.
Yes.
Moreover, ma'am, such parallel proceedings had also given rise to numerous instances of conflict between the laws. Four different agencies, the High Courts, the Company Law Board, the Board for Industrial and Financial Reconstruction, BIFR, and the Debt Recovery Tribunals, DRTs, have overlapping jurisdictions, giving rise to the potential of systematic delays and complexities in the process. Now, ma'am, this new bill addresses all these issues by bringing a new uniform code. I'm thankful to our Finance Minister. Ma'am, current insolvency proceedings take months, if not years. Average time is 4 years. Now, ma'am, this delay can acutely devalue the assets involved, thus making the insolvency negotiations redundant. The current disposition involves the institution of official liquidator, which is prone to red tapism, chronic corruption, and nepotism. The new code seeks to keep the role of adjudicator to the minimum. Currently, only 25% of the asset value is recovered by the creditors even after the liquidation process. That's a matter of great concern, ma'am. Now, how to deal with it? To deal with that, banks, all these compounded to the pitiable position of our public sector banks find themselves in, rising NPAs and mounting assets have also eroded their profits, as the recent SBI reports point out. The easing of liquidation process can help the banks recover a lot of bad debts.
Yes.
Ma'am, formerly, here in our country, any change in the legal system were hard to enforce. That's the reality. But now, with the changed attitude of our government and under the able guidance of our Honorable Finance Minister, this code has proposed a massive overhaul of laws, procedures and infrastructures. There is no doubt that once the code is fully implemented, it is going to be one of the best initiatives by the legislature and a boon to the economy in the broader sense.
Thank you.
Ma'am, I offer my sincere gratitude to our Honorable Prime Minister and Finance Minister, Shri Arun Jaitley Ji, for bringing this bill, and I fully support it. Thank you so much.